Pat Cyber Cabaret, celebrating the 6th birthday for Central Alabama Theater, starring Golden Globe and Emmy Award winner Sally Struthers, Grammy nominee and Dove Award winner Ty Herndon, Grammy winner and star of the Tony Award winning musical Hadestown, Reeve Carney, American Idol's power couple and Broadway veterans Diana Degarmo and Ace Young, Birmingham's own the Dill Pickers, Miss Alabama Tierra Pennington, singer, actress, and vocal performance instructor at New York City's AMDA, Emily Herring, singer-songwriter Jada Cato, and the Cat Junior Advisory Board. And now, from the blockbuster movie The Parent Trap, Romy and Michelle's high school reunion, superstar, and currently starring as Alexis Carrington Colby in the CW's new Dynasty, our co-host for this birthday extravaganza, Elaine Hendrix.
Oh, thank you so much. What an introduction. But hey, you all forgot that I'm also a Central Alabama Theater Advisory Board member. Big supporter right here. That's why I'm so happy to be joining you and this incredible list of artists that Cat Cyber Cabaret has in store for you. Oh my gosh, let me tell you something. Even though the 2020 schedule has been postponed, no pandemic is gonna keep us performers from entertaining you, no siree. It's our 6th birthday and we're still ready to celebrate with you. It's our birthday, but we're giving you the gift for being such incredible supporters of Cat Central Alabama Theater. Woohoo! Yay! So, we still got bills piling up. Whatever donation you can make, check out the link below. Every penny helps. Whatever you can do is mucho, mucho appreciated for our nonprofit theater here. It is our 6th birthday. Where were you when you were 6 years old?
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Central Alabama Theater!
Woo, you're a big 6 years old. Golly, when I was 6 years old, I remember singing Beauty and the Beast.
I remember learning how to ride a bike without training wheels.
Whoa.
Congratulations.
Have a great day.
Happy birthday, Cat. 6 years. This is me at 6 years of age. I got my ears pierced and I started playing piano, taking lessons. So, that was a great year. Here's to many more with Kat. Love you.
Hi, it's Jim Newman, and happy 6th birthday, Central Alabama Theater. I remember on my 6th birthday, I was in first grade, we had a little party, and Ray Burns was sitting behind Suzanne Page. Ray Burns got sick, and Ray Burns threw up all over Suzanne Page's hair. I mean, that's the best gift you can give a 6-year-old.
It's Central Alabama Theater's 6th birthday, and so I'm gonna sing you a very peppy birthday song. It's your birthday, oh, it's your birthday. Theater's closing everywhere, but happy birthday. Happy birthday, Central Alabama Theater. And for my 6th birthday, my mother baked me a cake that had coconut on it because my sister likes coconut and her birthday is a week before mine and we had to share our birthday. So I cried a lot and she sent me to my room. That was my 6th birthday.
My name is Kelly Dodd and I'm so excited to help wish Central Alabama Theater a very happy 6th birthday. Muy feliz cumpleaños. Love and miss you all. Happy birthday, Kat.
Hello, my name is Michael James Leslie, and I would like to say congratulations to the Central Alabama Theater on their 6th anniversary. When I reach my 6th birthday, dinosaurs still roam the earth.
Happy 6th birthday, Central Alabama Theater.
You know, it seems like it was yesterday when I had my sixth birthday. I was living in Mobile. I was in kindergarten at St. Dominic's. Mrs. Armstrong was my teacher, and my birthday was in March of 1937. And my mother had planned an Easter egg hunt birthday party. It was so much fun. I had on a green and white polka dotted Swiss dress with little lace around the puppy sleeves, and I wore a big crinoline underneath, and it was just so much. This isn't about me, is it? It isn't. It's about you, Central Alabama Theater. Happy sixth birthday. I wish you six more, and six more after that, and six more after that, and six more after that, and whew, all the sixes.
Happy sixth anniversary, Central Alabama Theater. My memory from when I was 6 years old is that I never cut my hair. Never. I let it grow way down below my hips. And given our current circumstances, I think everybody else is going to be letting their hair grow too. And my six-year-old self secretly loves it.
Happy birthday, Kat. When I turned six, I had an Anastasia-themed birthday party. Anastasia, like the cartoon movie that's not historically accurate whatsoever, but still everybody loves it. But nobody loved it as much as I did because I had a whole party about it. And my mom made us, everybody that came, she made them costumes from the movie. And we all wore them and we all looked beautiful. And then my grandmother dressed up as the Dowager Empress and we had a tea party in our dining room. And it was great. And I'm sure your sixth birthday will be just as great. So happy birthday.
Happy sixth anniversary, Central Alabama Theater.
Happy sixth birthday, Central Alabama Theater. When I was six, I was probably running around New York City trying desperately to find Italian ices before the date of, like, some date in June when they would be finally available in Little Italy in New York. That might make no sense, but that's what I did when I was 6 years old.
Happy sixth birthday, Central Alabama Theater. Congratulations on your 6 years of success. When I was 6 years old, I remember starting first grade and looking forward to all the years ahead of me and hopefully all the successes to come. So, congratulations and many more.
Happy birthday to Kat. Happy birthday to Kat. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy sixth birthday, Central Alabama Theater. And special thanks to my very favorite accompanist, Rolf the Dog. We wish you many, many more. Love you. Bye.
Happy birthday to you.
Where was I? We'll take a look. At 6 years old, I already had a microphone in my hand, taps on my shoes, and I was on the stage ready to entertain the world, just like I am now. So hey, let's get this party started. First up is a Grammy-nominated Dove Award-winning recording artist with 20 Billboard charted singles, 5 million albums sold, with 3 number one hits, Living in a Moment, What Mattered Most, and It Must Be Love, my very dear friend, Mr. Ty Herndon.
So, Ty, it's good to see you again.
Hello. I've been seeing you all over my TV, Miss Alexis Carrington from Dynasty. Oh, my God. It's just so amazing to be able to turn on my TV and see my friend. I have a lot of friend actors, but, you know, we've been friends a long time. So it's like watching my sister on TV. And can we talk just for a minute about wardrobe? Hello.
I know. Well, listen, it's not coming out of my closet, so.
Well, I came out of mine, so that's pretty good. Listen.
Well done, my friend. Well done.
We've got some great footage of all these costumes, so roll that beautiful beat footage.
I'm a little bit Alexis. Everybody's got a pool boy. Everybody's got a horse. Everybody's got a billboard. Everybody's got a vault.
It's locked.
Everybody's got a stalker. Everybody's got a horse.
But now, you've got Alexis.
Oh, I love that. Yay!
Right?
And I want the audience to know this is not the first time that you and I have teamed up for Central Alabama Theater. Two summers ago, we co-hosted their Christmas in July event to raise much-needed funds for them.
Yes, we did. And, oh my gosh, it was so hot. Remember, we were just sweating. We were just sweating so bad.
It was hot like us.
It was hot like us. Hallelujah. But it was much cooler. I had the honor of doing this Christmas show with the Central Alabama Theater last December with a beautiful song that actually my good buddy Carl Peoples, John Blaylock, and I had the pleasure of writing, God rest his soul, but I know he was watching down, the beautiful song called A Not So Silent Night.
Yes, which is the title of the show, right?
Absolutely. It was the title of the whole production. And I will say, it's the first time in my life I got to ride out on a Christmas carriage on a stage. It was pretty cool.
Oh, well, yeehaw. Well, I got a little show and tell of my own, Ty. I have a clip of you, Ty Herndon, in A Not So Silent Night.
I see my children laughing and running around the tree. With dreams so big and hopes so loud, they'll never go to sleep. And I see my newborn crying, lying in his mother's arms. And I think I know what Joseph felt on the night that Christ was born. Every bell did ring, and every voice did sing a song to celebrate the Savior's birth. Every heart cried out.
Friend. And hey, if you want to see more productions like that with the Central Alabama Theater, go to the link below. Just look below, you'll see a link there. Go to it and make a donation. No donation is too small. Every single penny helps in the nonprofit world, I promise you.
I'm already partying over here because I'm going to tell you right now, we're going to reach that goal. And I want to tell you right now, this is pretty cool. The first four people to donate $1,000 right now gets an amazing dinner with little old me. We're going to be right there in Birmingham. We're going to have the most amazing Woo! Night. So right now, ready? Do it.
Woohoo! You heard the man, folks. The first four people to donate $1,000 or more gets a free dinner in Birmingham, Alabama with Ty Herndon. So all you have to do is donate $1,000 or more. Get yourself down to Birmingham, Alabama, and you get a free dinner with Ty Herndon. And we're going to throw in Mr. Carl Peoples for dessert. So that is amazing, Ty. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. You know what? We're going to reach that goal, everybody.
Yes, we are going to meet our goal. And I understand that you are going to sing for us later, live, right?
You got it.
Yes, sirree. Okay, well, great. I know the next performer coming up is someone you met doing A Not So Silent Night with Central Alabama Theater.
You know, I fell in love with this entire cast, to be honest with you. But this young lady, she's actually a member of the Junior Advisory Board. And man, she's mind-blowing. I hope to produce her one day. And I told her, I said, when you're selling out arenas, one day when we can do that again, I'm totally opening. So ladies and gentlemen, put your ears on for this amazing artist, Miss Jada Cato.
Because The Parent Trap was one of my go-to movies growing up, so just a little fangirl moment.
Oh, well, wonderful, because it's now a mutual admiration society then.
Yes, you're going to have to tell me when we're done off camera how they got the lizard in your mouth in the lake scene.
Oh, yes, some movie magic. We'll talk off screen. Hey, so who were all those very talented people with you?
Those were some of the fabulous members of the Junior Advisory Board at CAT. That was Jackson Massey, Melanie Hollenstein, Tiara Pennington, Matthew Torbett, Virginia Barr, Benjamin Kitchens, and Rachel Lockhart. Just a few of my amazingly talented JAB members.
Wow, that is quite a group, and well done on remembering everybody's names. So tell me more about the Junior Advisory Board, also known as JAB.
So JAB is 12 members from juniors in high school all the way to 26 years of age. You apply yearly, and when you get in your first year, you spend that time shadowing someone in the theater, getting to know the ropes, whether it be directing, stage managing, design of some kind, sound, lights, costumes, anything like that. And a JAB member always opens for the Cat Cabarets.
What an incredible program, what incredible opportunities. So what has JAB done for you in your career?
Oh my gosh, so much. I've opened for a Cat Cabaret, and last December I was cast in A Not So Silent Night, which is a beautiful, lovely Christmas musical written by our dear Carl Peoples. And we did that in collaboration with Ty Herndon. And after that, Ty has a $2,500 grant with GLAAD called the Rising Star Grant. And I applied nationally and won, so I'm the 2019 Rising Star. And after that, I got a management deal, and I think it's safe to say that when quarantine is over, I am going to Nashville to record a duet with Ty.
Woo! Well deserved. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, so it's worked out well for you. I mean,
yes.
It sounds like it's okay, right?
It's got some perks. You know, there are a ton of success stories in the Junior Advisory Board, mainly because Carl is such an amazing mentor and just really connects so well with people.
Oh. Well, congratulations. That's an incredible opportunity. Well done. And
yay. Thank you so much, Elaine.
So speaking of the gentleman with the eye for talent, let's all please welcome the founder and artistic director of Central Alabama Theater and its junior advisory board, my very dear friend, Mr. Carl Peoples. Woo!
Wow! Woo! Thanks, Elaine. Woo, I've been watching the show the first few minutes. You guys are blowing me away. The love and the generosity, it's already a party. Thank you.
Yes, well deserved. And you have put together one heck of a lineup.
Well, thank you. It's all you guys. And I want everybody at home to know that all of these artists tonight have donated their time and their talent to Central Alabama Theater for our sixth birthday. And it's just amazing the help that has come to the forefront after the 2020 season had to be postponed because of this pandemic. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We thank you.
Yes, well, you know performers. Heck, if you got a driveway, we'll put on a show. So
it's true.
We're not letting you down.
You got a barn, you got a horse, yay, let's do it.
Absolutely. Well, and hey, did you hear Ty say that he is donating to the first four people who donate $1,000 or more? He's donating a dinner. They're in Birmingham.
I did.
And yes, and then the donate link will be at the bottom of your screen all through the performance. So you can just copy that link into your browser. It'll take you to the site of Central Alabama Theater where you can make a much needed donation to help this amazing theater keep going.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, I did hear that challenge. That's pretty amazing. And I hope those four donors have already come in. But I actually have a little challenge of myself, but it's a tad bit smaller. So for my last birthday, my 82-year-old dad, being the artisan woodworker that he is, made me this little jewel, which is an iPad and phone holder made of solid black walnut. And when I posted a picture of it online, everybody and their brother wanted to know where they could get theirs. Of course, it's a Dwight Peoples original, so I said, sorry, nowhere. But when we started the show, my dad wanted to be a part of it. So he got down in his basement and made us 20 of those for the first 20 people that donate $50 or more. As a thank you, Central Alabama Theater is going to send you your very own solid black walnut iPad iPhone holder for your home right there. So jump online on the link below, make your donation of $50 or more, and you get your very own Dwight Peoples piece of art.
Me, I'm getting one. Right after I'm done here, my first break.
I have a feeling that all you'd have to do is ask Mr. Dwight for one. Elaine, you pretty much have him wrapped around your little finger anyway, so.
Well, I know, but listen, I get to make a donation and get a beautiful gift,
go.
So I'm not missing that opportunity.
There you go. We'll go for that. Hey, I'm glad you said theater folks earlier about putting on a show in the driveway, because most everybody knows Elaine Hendrix from the movies and television. Not a lot of people know that you actually got your start on the theater. I mean, you're a thespian. That's actually where we met. We met in a show called Heartstrings in Atlanta, Georgia at the Fox Theater.
Yes, and we have been sharing the stage ever since.
We certainly have.
Yeah, we do well with all of our plotting and scheming. Ha 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 ha. And then, of course, we do plot and scheme. Yes, we do. And then you have been such a good friend to come see me in some of my productions. Like, you came when I did my regional production of Streetcar Named Desire. And then you also came when I made my off-Broadway debut doing It's Just Sex.
Of course. How could I miss your off-Broadway debut? It was amazing. I loved it. Loved, loved, loved it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So now we just got to figure out how to get you to Birmingham and get in your schedule for to have you perform at Central Alabama Theater.
Yeah, 100%. Done.
So speaking of performing, I actually asked you when we first started talking about this show, if you would perform tonight, and you said, okay, look, time management, I'll either co-host the show or I'll perform in the show, but not both.
I can't do both. Well, co-hosting's kind of performing.
It is, and it's a big deal, but after thinking about it, I thought, you know, we've done a lot of benefit shows together. We've done a couple of movies together. I just happen to have a little rehearsal clip of you that I've always thought was fabulous.
Oh, no. What are you doing, Carl Peoples?
Well, I just thought I would share with the rest of the world how fabulous you are on stage, just like TV and film. And plus, I really think that this is a role that you should actually play at some point. It's so dang good. So, with your permission, ladies and gentlemen, a little rehearsal time with Miss Elaine Hendrix as Roxy. Now, if that don't get you up to donate for Central Alabama Theater, nothing will. I'm telling you, you should play that role.
Well, you sneaky devil, maybe we just found what we can do together for Central Alabama Theater.
Wow, that would be amazing. Yes. Okay, you just got my brain twirling right now, okay? It's going.
And I'm flush over here. I'm cooling myself off.
You're trying to get me flush over here, too. I'm like, all right, girl, work it out.
Okay, well, moving right along.
Moving right along.
This is going to be the one and only time throughout this whole show that you see me put on my glasses and pick up a piece of paper to introduce our next guest, because she is legendary, and I don't want to miss not one syllable of what's written here, because she has earned every single word and more. Let me tell you something, but, you know, we got a show to move on to, so I can only say so much, but here we go. Our next performer played the role of Gloria, the daughter of Archie and Edith Bunker, in the hit series All in the Family, where she won not one, but two Emmys. And it wasn't just Emmys she won. She also won Golden Globe Awards for her portrayal. She has also played Babette on The Gilmore Girls and was the voice of Charlene Sinclair on the ABC sitcom Dinosaurs and Reba Cunningham on the Disney animated series Tailspin. She also has toured the world playing Louise in the hit stage production of Always Patsy Cline. Please welcome my friend, the legendary Sally Struthers.
I could while away the hours conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain and my head. I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. So if the rock and roll singer Meatloaf married Russian gymnast Nadja Comaneci, she'd be Nadja Comaneci Meatloaf.
Sally Struthers, you are one of the funniest people I know, and I am so honored to call you my friend. Now let's get back to my beautiful co-host, Miss Elaine Hendrix, who is with another dear friend who has been part of the Cat family since the very beginning, Broadway veteran Catherine Freeze Vaughn. Take it away, ladies.
Catherine, thank you so much for being a part of Central Alabama's sixth birthday and supporting our friend, Mr. Carl Peoples.
Thank you, Elaine. Thank you so much for having me.
Of course, and you are a veteran Broadway singer, dancer, actor, producer, director, teacher. I mean, you do it all.
Thank you. I've been very fortunate to have longevity, and I keep reinventing myself as I go.
Yes, well, very, very wise words. And for those who don't know, Catherine originated the role of Sister Monica Mary in the original production of Do Black Patent Leather Shoes Really Reflect Up? She's also performed at Radio City Music Hall many times. She was in the national tour of Beauty and the Beast. And then she and Carl met doing a show in Tahoe.
That's right. We met in rehearsal for a casino show, which we did for 6 months, and formed a little bit of a singing duo at that point, and have stayed friends for 25 years now, if you can believe.
I can believe. That's easy to do with Mr. Carl Peoples.
That's right.
So what did you think when he told you, Hey, my friend Kathy, I'm going to start a theater in Central Alabama.
I was very excited when he came up with the idea to bring theater to his community. I think regional theater is so important, and it's going to be especially important when we all come back from this time that we're going through right now.
Yes, very much so. And I understand you actually hosted the very first benefit for Central Alabama Theater called Broadway to Birmingham, and you hosted it in New York.
I did. I think people thought that we were a little bit crazy when we decided to have a benefit in New York City for a theater in Alabama, but we got a lot of people together who knew Carl or who knew him through me, and they were excited about having more regional theater too. And we had our performers sitting on either side of the stage which the cabaret also thought was crazy to have performers actually sitting out watching one another. But what happened was that it turned into a great big party and everybody was cheering one another on, and it was an exciting kickoff, I think, for the theater.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, listen, I think people think folks in New York are crazy anyway, so what does that
that's
matter?
Right. That's right.
Yeah, so hey, I think people in New York are crazy and fabulous and wonderful and creative, because we just are. So we have a clip of that show. So everyone, please enjoy Broadway to Birmingham and Catherine Freeze Vaughn.
Your time has come to shine. All your dreams are on their way. Oh, if you need a friend, that's
to Birmingham. Wow.
It really was. It was very exciting.
Yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say we're looking forward to more of the same in the future, to gathering together and having a community of actors and performers. And I'm looking forward to what the future is going to hold for all of us too.
Yay! Yes, yes, yes. And you've actually also been down to Birmingham many times to perform, not just supporting from New York, but you're actually boots on the ground down there.
Yes. The first thing that I did was a cat cabaret, a show that I wrote based on Judy Garland. It was Judy, the music and humor of Judy Garland. And I had the opportunity to workshop it at Central Alabama Theater, which was great for me to have that kickoff from them.
Oh, absolutely. Well, listen, I know that they love having you. We love having you. You're part of the family. Thank you so much. Thank you for all your support that you've given to Central Alabama, and happy sixth birthday to them.
Happy sixth birthday.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was Catherine Freeze Vaughn, and now we're gonna get back over to Carl in Birmingham.
Oh, that was fantastic. Thank you very much. Our next guest is from right here in Birmingham, Alabama, and is a part of our Junior Advisory Board at Central Alabama Theater. But her real claim to fame is she is 2019 and 2020 Miss Alabama. I'll let her explain that to you. Please put your hands together and welcome Miss Tiara Pennington. Hi, Tiara Pennington. Welcome to Cat Cyber Cabaret.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
Oh, we're just thrilled. We're absolutely thrilled. How is being at home and doing all of these interviews from home working out for you? Have you got all the technical ideas under wrap now?
Well, I definitely think I am learning when it comes to technology. I've learned so much over just the span of a couple of weeks. And, you know, they always say young people, oh, we already know how to work technology. But there are some things that I do not know. And I definitely now know them all about Zoom and every other app pertaining to be able to talk to other people and having social distancing. So I've learned a lot.
That's good. Again, thank you for being here. You were crowned almost a year ago as
yes,
Miss
sir.
Alabama. And before that, the preliminary you won was Miss University of Alabama. Am I correct?
It was.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And am I right in saying you were the first African-American to be crowned Miss University of Alabama?
I sure was.
What a thrill. Tell us about that. How did that make you feel? How that lineage is cool.
It is so cool. And honestly, I did not know that that was even a thing. You know, I had thought with all of the years that this whole organization has been going on, I would have for sure thought that at the University of Alabama, we would have already had a woman of color to win that title. So I won and was just excited that, yay, like I finally made it back to Miss Alabama, and I'm so glad that I get to represent my university. And then I'm backstage and they're like, not only did you just win, which is awesome, but you're the first African American to win the title of Miss University of Alabama. And my jaw almost fell to the floor. I could not believe that. I'm like, are you sure?
Well, you make a very good point. Did being the first African-American, or as you say, woman of color to be crowned as Miss University of Alabama, did that open doors that maybe some other Miss University of Alabamas hadn't had?
I definitely think it did. I think one thing from being the first African-American to win that title, a lot more people I think on campus were like, ooh, we hear this girl who's the first African-American won the title of Miss University of Alabama. So I feel like it really changed the whole culture of the campus, because at the University of Alabama, we're really big on football and sports.
Of course.
But people were more interested in learning about the organization. And I think I was really able to connect with others on campus about, you know, this isn't just a beauty competition, but we are winning scholarship money, and the reason that I'm here today on campus is because of the full tuition scholarship that I have gained through this organization. So I think it opened a lot of different doors for a lot of people on campus just learning more about the organization.
Absolutely.
I was actually the first Miss University of Alabama to win Miss Alabama. So I learned that on that night that I won.
Wow.
And I was just,
you had a lot of
firsts. So I did, and I was like, no, you are kidding me. Just going through my mind all these incredible women I know who have held the title and have eventually gone on to win Miss Alabama, but they didn't win it when they were Miss University of Alabama. So I was like, oh my goodness, now I'm really about to hit the floor.
That's awesome. So you've had a exciting year. It's been a little different in the fact that Miss America was somewhere different this year. That sort of started the ball rolling on a different take on your whole year. And now tell us a little bit about all the changes that have happened, and we've sort of expanded to now you're going to be serving the state of Alabama, which we're thrilled about, for 2 years as Miss Alabama.
I will. I've been able to experience a lot through this full year of being Miss Alabama, and I know that I will experience even more with being Miss Alabama for a second year, and it's just a blessing, and it's something that I never expected, because you always know that this is just a one-time job, once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And so to get that call that, hey, because of all this craziness that's going on with the coronavirus, you know, we want to make sure that the next winner has an opportunity to have the same experience you had of going to Miss America and having a full year of reaching out to people in the community. So to make sure that that happens, I get another year, which I'm super excited about that, and hopefully do things a lot better this time around.
Well, we are thrilled to have you represent Alabama another year. So thank you.
Thank you.
Let's go back a little bit further, a little bit before that, when you first got involved with Central Alabama Theater and with our Junior Advisory Board, which everyone calls JAB because that age group, everything's an acronym.
So true.
Yeah. You opened for a couple of cat cabarets for us as a JAB member. Then you came and auditioned for a Christmas show. You want to tell us about that experience?
Oh my goodness, my dream come true. Besides the fact of becoming Miss Alabama, yeah, I've always loved to sing, and that was one of the things that kind of got me involved in this organization, just wanting to share my talent with others. So when I found out that we were going to have a Not So Silent Night Christmas show, I wanted to audition and definitely wanted to be a part of. I mean, who does not want to be a part of a Christmas show?
Yeah.
And to find out that this big star, I mean, Ty Herndon, was going to be a part of it, it was going to take time to come down here to Alabama and to perform with all of us who are just trying to figure out this whole thing about show business and performing, was going to be there in the show. I just had to audition and had to try out. And so it was so much fun getting to be a part of that show and actually getting to do a little song with Ty Herndon and to be able to have those good times and good memories with all of my JAB members. And it's just a moment that I will never forget. So much fun.
Perfect. Well, thank you, TR. We are so proud of you. And I'll let you go get ready to sing while I tell the folks, ladies and gentlemen, we are thrilled to have not only Miss Alabama, but our JAB member, Miss Tiara Pennington, with her version of the prayer.
And help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Lead us to a place, guide us with your grace, to a place where we'll be safe.
I'd unravel every riddle for every individual in trouble or in pain. With the thoughts I'd be thinking, I could be another Lincoln if I only had a brain. So if the actor Hal March's grandson married the actress Tuesday Weld, she'd be Tuesday March the 2nd.
Yes! Woo! Well, Norton Dill, thank you so much. You and the Dill Pickers. Boy, the brain just really wants to go somewhere else with that. But you and the Dill Pickers,
being here at the Central Alabama's 6th birthday party.
We are totally thrilled to be involved, I'm telling you. I was so excited when Carl called about it, and then when I contacted the rest of the pickers, and they're spread out over Alabama and Tennessee, they were immediately excited and said, yes, we're in.
Oh, yay, yes, like all of us showing up for this great yeah. guy. Yeah. And you all, you have not only, you're not only an advisory board member like myself, and very involved with the theater, but you've also already gotten to direct and perform with the theater.
I know, I've got the whole package, don't I? I mean, it's amazing how having Carl Peoples come to Birmingham again has been such a joy for, not just for me and the Dill Pickers, but for the entire theater community. And was so lucky that really, as soon as he got here, we got together and started talking. And at that point, I thought this is going to be great if he can pull it off. And here, 6 years later, he has more than pulled it off. It's just, it's a bright spot in my life and in the theater community in Birmingham, for sure.
Oh, well, if anyone can pull it off, Carl Peoples certainly is the
Absolutely,
man for that.
Yeah.
Well, and I understand that you were very influential in the very first show that Central Alabama did at your Steeple Arts Center.
Yeah. Now, of course, Carl had been doing cabaret shows. The Dill Pickers had done a cabaret show. We'd even done one of our old-time radio shows. But as far as doing a scripted musical, Carl came to me and said, hey, what could we do? We went over and looked at Steeple Arts. Now, I've been familiar with Steeple Arts for a long time. My wife is a dancer, choreographer, and so she knew all of the dance places in town. And, of course, Steeple Arts was one of the first Methodist churches in Birmingham. But since, I believe, the mid-50s has been a dance studio. And when Carl told me that that was going to be the new performing space for Cat Cabaret, I was thrilled to get to go over there and take a tour. As soon as I walked in the door, I thought, this would be absolutely perfect for Smoke on the Mountain. Smoke on the Mountain, such a great show. I don't know what the stats on it now are, but for many years, it was the most performed show, I think for at least 12 or 13 years, most performed musical show in the United States. And of course it's set in a little country church, a little wooden country church, and that's what Steeple Art, yeah, it's just absolutely perfect, you know.
Well, I've been over to the Steeple Arts location, and it is really something quite mm-hmm. special. And I know we have a clip Ooh. From the Smoke on the Mountain show, so let's watch.
Let's have a look.
Branding souls with death and sin.
looks like a bundle of fun.
Oh, it is so much fun. And as a matter of fact, this show, Smoke on the Mountain, not at Central Alabama Theater, but the first time we did it was in 1999. And that is why the Dill Pickers are together today. We got together to do that show. And over the next quite a few years, did it at several theaters around town. And the next thing you know, people were inviting us to come play, and we didn't have a name. So we decided to name ourselves. I was the only member who voted against the name the Dill Pickers. But it was only because I didn't think my name had to be in the name of the group. But it's turned out to be a great sort of tongue-in-cheek name for us, you know.
Oh, well, it's a fantastic name. You certainly don't forget it. And no. You mentioned your wife, Lonnie, and I know that it's just an absolute love fest between you all and Carl and you all, and you all have been such big supporters and mentors to the community there.
Well, we are so fortunate to have not only this theater relationship with Carl, but a personal relationship. And Lonnie has been involved in the theater community for years and years and years. And she and I have directed a lot of things together. She's done stuff by herself. I've done stuff by myself. But we are in total agreement. Lonnie and I are in total agreement that what Carl has done with Central Alabama Theater is something that's totally unique in Birmingham, and something that obviously is much needed because of the support that it has gotten. And the shows have just been fantastic, you know.
Well, I second that. I sixth that. I sixth birthday that sentiment
there
right
go.
There.
Yeah.
Hey, so yeah. I know that you, Norton Dill, and the... what if we had not had the Dill Pickers? What if it had not been named that? I fret at that story, but I know that you're performing, so who all you got here, and what are you performing for us?
Okay, and I hope I don't embarrass myself and forget somebody's name. Let's start with the ladies. Teresa McKibben, who's from here in Birmingham. Leslie Wright, who is married to Neyland Wright. Leslie and Neyland live in Knoxville, Tennessee.
Whoop, whoop!
Yep. Scotty Stewart, who lives in Arrington, Tennessee, or somewhere close around there. They're out in the country. And Ken Coe, who lives here in Birmingham. And all of us are the original six Dill Pickers. And we've been together since 1999. Long time.
Very long time indeed. Well, hey, here is Norton Dill and the Dill Pickers with Hard Times.
Let us pause in life's pleasure and count how many tears while we all sup sorrow with the poor. There's a song that will linger forever in our ears. Oh, hard times come again no more.
Song the sigh of the weary. Hard times come again no more. Many days you have lingered around my cabin door. Oh, hard times come again no more.
While we seek mirth and beauty,
tis a wail that's heard upon the shore. Tis
a dirge that is murmured around the lovely grave. Oh, hard times come again no more.
Tis a song
Thanks, guys. That was fantastic. Our next guest has been a part of the Central Alabama Theater from the very beginning. Please help me welcome Cat Advisory Board member and my friend, Miss Emily Herring.
Hi, everybody. Hi, Carl.
Thanks for being a part of this tonight. And we were so excited that you were part of the very first kickoff in New York City. That was a pretty special night, huh?
I cannot believe you asked me to be a part of that. I was so honored to join the esteemed cast of, Broadway veterans. And it was just, it was such an electric, like, just magical night of energy. And
I've never
sung for an audience like that, ever. You have a mix of Alabama people and New York people and Friends of Carl Peoples people. And then it's just a huge party. I mean, it was so much fun.
It was quite a party. But you were also our very first Cat Cabaret 6 years ago on May 18th in Birmingham. What do you remember about that night?
So much. I remember having coffee with you, and you told me that you were starting this theater company, and I was like, that is perfect, and this is perfect timing. I felt like Birmingham needed just something different and more, and just a unique theater experience. It was obviously an honor, and I could not wait to sing my favorite jazz song.
It was fantastic.
What about that venue? Oh my gosh.
Well, it was the perfect venue, really. I mean, Bob McKenna and the Clubhouse on Highland is super special. We did have a blast. Then you came back a year later and performed for our first birthday celebration with a tribute to your vocal coach, the late, great Marnie Nixon. What a special night that was, huh?
Yes. That was an emotional night. Marnie was actually going to sing with me on that. And we had worked on, singing together on some duets and some things that she had done.
You and I had just met with her in New York about that very thing.
And she was very excited and she wanted to do it. But, not much could stop Marnie Nixon. But cancer, unfortunately, did stop her from doing this. So she was with us in spirit and was thrilled to know what a success it was. And it was neat to tell anecdotes and a little trivia and stories about Marnie that no one really knew, that I had inside scoop on.
Well, then the next season at Cat, you were cast in our summer show, The Bikinis. What was that like?
Well, first of all, when you asked me to be in a show called The Bikinis, I ran as fast as I could because I am not putting a bikini on for nobody. But you told me that we were not wearing bikinis. So I said, sure, I'll do it. And all the other women in the show with me, Monique Gannon, Natalie Collins, and Kathy Freeze Vaughn, we're all the same age range, and none of us wanted to wear bikinis. So once we found out that that was not a must, we had a blast, fun, energetic. No one had heard of the show. I mean, you just find the most unique plays and musicals and shows that no one's really heard of. So Birmingham loved it. It was a blast. And Chip Williams was a musical director. He was super fun, right?
Wasn't he a blast? He did a great job. So tell us, what are you singing for our sixth birthday celebration?
The song I chose is a thank you to our organizations like Central Alabama Theater and everyone involved in the arts that gives artists an opportunity to showcase their talents. And it's a special place to be.
Well, thank you.
So I hope you enjoy it.
Well, thank you. We appreciate you very much. We can't wait. So without any further ado, here she is, folks, helping to celebrate our sixth birthday, the incomparable Miss Emily Herring.
Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be? Without a song or a dance, what are we? So why
I'm nothing special. In fact, I'm a bit of a bore. If I tell a joke, you probably heard it before. But I have a talent, a wonderful thing, 'cause everyone listens when I start to sing. I'm so grateful and proud. All I want is to sing it out loud. So I say thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me. I've been so lucky. I am the girl with golden hair. I wanna see.
Happy birthday, Kat. Love you.
Woo, yes. Thank you for the music. We thank you for the music, Emily Herring. Beautiful job, Emily. And thank you for all the music over the years here at Central Alabama Theater.
Thank you. Love you.
Oh, I could tell you why. The ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thunk before. And then I'd sit and think some more. So if the president ex-wife married singer Neil Diamond and then left him to marry Jack Nicklaus, the golfer, she'd be Ivana Diamond Nicklaus. Ivana Diamond Nicklaus.
These next performers are two of the most talented and sweetest people I know, and I've known them for a while. You met them individually on season 3 and 5 of American Idol. They met on Broadway in the cast of Hair, and a few years ago, they went back to American Idol to solidify their relationship. Take a look at this.
We've got lots of Idol alum in the house tonight. Good to see all your faces back here. We got our first American Idol couple, Ace Young and Diana DeGarmo. Aw, how cute. Come on up here for a second. You guys are too cute. Come on up here for a second on the stage. Give it up for Ace and Diana. It's amazing what can happen out of this show. Here, let me give you this. I hear that you guys, you have some big news. You moved in together, is that right?
Yes, we did.
Oh, that's cool. Congratulations.
Thank you. And this has always been home to us, and I felt that this would be the perfect place to ask a simple question.
Wow. Kieran, dim the lights. Here we go.
I love you to death. You're my best friend, Diana Nicole DeGarmo. Will you marry me?
singing a song they co-wrote as the title track from her recent EP. Please welcome to the Central Alabama Theater virtual stage, Broadway veterans, Diana Degarmo and Ace Young singing Live to Love. Job. Diana Degarmo and Ace Young, ladies and gentlemen. Amazing job, you dynamic duo, you. If I was there, I'd give you both a big high five. There you go. Thanks, guys.
I would not be just enough and my head all full of stuff and my heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry. Life would be a ding-a-dairy. If I only had a brain. So if Senator Birchbeck's wife, Viola, left him to marry actor Jack Black, and then left Jack to marry Admiral Byrd, and then left Admiral Byrd and went back to Senator Birchbeck, she'd be Vi-Bye Blackbird, Vi-Bye.
Bye-bye, Blackbird, bye-bye. Where does she get this stuff? Sally, you are a hoot, I tell ya. Well, hey, let's get back over to Birmingham with Mr. Carl Peoples. He has another friend and supporter of Central Alabama Theater, a Broadway veteran, and the star of Hadestown, Mr. Reeve Carney.
Reeve, man, first of all, thanks so much for being a part of Central Alabama Theater's sixth birthday. We really can't thank you enough, man.
Oh, yeah, no problem, Carl. Thanks for inviting me. I appreciate you guys reaching out, and I wish we could be there in person.
Yeah, we do too. So maybe we'll have to make that happen down the road. That would be great. Dude, I feel like you're living the charmed life. I mean, first of all, your gift and your voice is transcendent. You're a great songwriter. You're one of Broadway's favorite leading men. You're starring in a Tony Award-winning musical with one of Broadway's most talented and stunning co-stars. I guess I feel like I should say, what's the secret of life, dude? We all want to know it.
I mean, now more than ever, I think it's important to think this way because we are all stuck sort of away from one another. But in general, I don't know, not that I have any secrets, but I think, you know, gratitude is very important, and I'm sure that you think of things in the same way, and I'm sure most of the people watching are aware of that sort of way of thinking. I think that, you know, you've got to be grateful for sometimes you have to be grateful for incredibly small things because that's all you have, and then other times as long as you train yourself to be grateful for the small things, I think being grateful for the bigger things obviously comes much easier. So
I think that's right.
I think that helps, yeah.
Well, and you said gratitude. I think gratitude is an action.
Yeah.
So, you know, you have to be thankful as an action every day for, like you said, the little things or the big things, whatever that is.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of some big things, of course, you played Dorian Gray in the Showtime series Penny Dreadful, where you were brilliant and it was a huge hit.
Thank you.
First big splash on Broadway was Peter Parker in the epic Broadway hit Spider-Man, Turn Off the Dark.
Yeah, which is
like 800 shows, is that right?
Yeah, I performed, did probably about 840 performances, but in Hadestown, I actually never missed a performance, which was really exciting for me. So I did
awesome.
all eight of that, and I'm excited to get back to that, I haven't mentioned my mustache, and you haven't mentioned it yet on here, but... I have never, because of that sort of thing, doing, you know, 8 shows a week, I've never had the chance to grow any sort of facial hair for more than 2 days.
Right.
So I don't necessarily love this, but it's been kind of fun to do it since I'm not really seeing many people these days. So I hope the audience will forgive this mustache.
It looks good. Oh, forgive it. It looks great. You and I were talking about it before we came on the air, and it was like, hey, man, that looks good. So, yeah.
It's funny.
So let's go back to Spider-Man for a minute. Looking back on Spider-Man, what was that experience like?
It was incredible. I mean, for me, it was my first really serious professional theater experience. I mean, I'd done a lot of, not a lot, but I'd done some children's theater as a kid and things like that, and then mainly just had focused on film and TV and obviously music on stage. But I think the only thing that made me sort of comfortable with it from the get-go was the amount of hours I'd spent on stage as a musician performing in front of audiences. So for me, that was helpful. But other than that, it was a brand new world for me.
Yeah.
So I think because it was a brand new world for me, it made it easy for me to kind of roll with the punches. No
sure,
pun intended with the Spider-Man reference, but I mean, but like really, you had. I mean, there were that was a an, it was a, ch- a uniquely challenging show in terms of getting it off the ground.
Yeah,
and I think that I didn't know anything other than that going into the world of Broadway in that way. So it's good, a good training ground for anybody entering the world of
everything else is a breeze after that, right?
I mean I don't know about everything, but certainly it makes a lot of things a lot easier
to handle.
I think maybe so, but yeah, I don't have to fly around in Hadestown, which is nice. I mean, I enjoyed that a lot, but it's definitely a little bit harder to focus on your acting when you're kind of thinking about
where
all
if you're
going to
run
stuff.
Into a wall.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
But
well, in Hadestown, let's jump to that. You kind of touched on it a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
You play Orpheus, who is the ultimate optimist, I guess, right?
Yeah. I mean, I definitely relate to Orpheus in that way. I think, you know, I'm hoping that we get to go back to perform for people sooner rather than later. Date keeps getting extended because of all of this.
Right.
But,
one of the cool things about Orpheus is that he thinks he can change the world if he can only write the perfect song, right?
Yeah.
or a beautiful enough song, I guess is a better way of putting. And you sort of already answered this, but how much of you do we see as a songwriter in that character?
I don't, you know, I think for me, the idea of Orpheus writing a song to change the world, to me, it could be taken literally, and in some ways that is possible. I mean, you look at songwriters like John Lennon and A.S. Mitchell,
sure.
People that, if you can, you know, be in that sort of category, I think it's pretty amazing, because people, you know, you do have the ability to do that with music and art, but I think also it's obviously a metaphor, and for me, I sort of think of it more along those lines.
Sure.
Maybe the song even being like the mode of thinking, like there's so much power we have in thought and consciousness and things like that. I think that you have the ability to, you know, if you can get on that wavelength and get enough people on that collective wavelength, then I think you genuinely do have the chance to change everything.
You're exactly right. Well, I mean, Spider-Man full of hope and humanity, Orpheus, the ultimate optimist. Maybe there's a bit of typecasting there when it's coming from you there.
Thanks. I mean, you know, it's kind of fun to play things that are really different from you as well. I mean, I think that's why I like playing Dorian Gray so much. There are certain things that, or, you know, and that's not even as different as I'd like to go. I'd like to go...
Well, there was Riff Raff.
I don't know. Yeah, Riff Raff's pretty odd. But it would be fun to play like a gangster or something. Like, yeah. I don't know. Like, something really just doesn't seem anything...
Hey, maybe connected. You just put it out to the universe then, right?
That would be great, yeah.
So, very good. So, I saw Hadestown a few months ago, and you and the entire cast, I mean, blew me away.
It was awesome.
It was amazing.
Thanks, Greg.
But I want you to share with our audience what it's like every night to play, not just with that cast, but next to a Broadway legend like Mr. Andre DeShields.
Oh, man, I miss Andre. I haven't seen him in person in like over 2 months now. But yeah, it's incredible. I mean, I'm so grateful that he finally, you know, got what he's deserved for so long in the Tonys last year. Which is actually kind of cool because I think he'll be the longest reigning best supporting male actor in a musical because there are no Tony Awards this year.
That's right.
So that'll be kind of cool.
It just extends for another 12 months. Right?
Yeah.
And so while you're getting ready to sing live for us, I'd like to show our audience a short clip of why they should run to the Walter Kerr Theater when it reopens to see you and the rest of the cast in the winner of 8 Tony Awards, including Best Musical, Hadestown. Watch this.
How to get to Hadestown? You have to take the long way down through the underground under cover of night, laying low, staying out of sight. Ain't no compass, brother. Ain't no map, just a telephone wire and a railroad track. Keep on walking and don't look back till you get to the bottom line.
Wait for me, I'm coming. Wait, I'm coming with you. Wait for me, I'm coming too. Come and wait for me.
Wait.
I hear the walls repeating.
Wait.
The falling of my feet and
the sounds like drumming.
Hadestown, ladies and gentlemen, at the Walter Kerr Theater on Broadway in New York City. But right here, right now, singing his rendition of the classic Over the Rainbow, please welcome to the Central Alabama Theater virtual stage, Mr. Reeve Carney.
Thank you.
lullaby. There's a land that I've heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are upon a star, and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Oh, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Happy 6th birthday, Cat Cabaret. Or Central Alabama Theater.
Wow.
Wow. Oh.
Amazing.
Be still, my heart. I have a new crush. Mr. Reeve Carney. Wow.
He is amazing, isn't he? That's crazy. Well, folks, Elaine told you at the beginning that we're going to have a party, and I think we've certainly done that. And she also asked you to dig deep and make a contribution to Central Alabama Theater at the link below. And thanks for all the donations that have already come in, and also for all the ones that are about to come in. And that means you. Yep, you at home. Elaine, thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart. I just want everybody to know that as a friend, you are always there. You always step up. You always have your friends back, and that includes me, and I love you for it. Thank you for being such a dear friend and a huge part of this evening.
Oh, it is my pleasure. Yes, absolutely. Gosh, I would do anything for you, Mr. Carl Peoples.
Back at you, sweetheart. Back at you.
Yeah, and for Central Alabama Theater, I think we had one heck of a party for 6 years old, huh?
We did. It was a heck of a lot of fun tonight.
Yes, we sure did. So I'm just going to wrap my little part up here with something that I always like to say when I end videos.
Sure.
That I want people to be kind to themselves. I'd like you to look out for our furry, feathered, and finned friends of this planet. They deserve our consideration. And if you need help, please ask for it. And if you have help to give, please give it.
That's right.
If we do all of that, this world will be in an even better place.
That's exactly right.
And so, as promised, wrapping up the show, our very dear friend.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for joining us tonight and singing his very appropriate single, Journey On. Let's say goodnight with the incomparable Mr. Ty Herndon.
Sometimes the mountains tower high above you. Sometimes it curves just too fast to swim. Oh, and life can carry you all kinds of places. Just heart before it falls to pieces and journey on. Journey on, hold your head above the water. Journey on, you can weather out this storm. Journey on, there's a better day coming. And it's a better day than we have ever known. Journey on, someone's waiting by the waiting there to take you by the hand. So make the most of all that you've been given. Journey on. Anybody's ship can take on water. You gotta make the choice to sink or swim. Just grab a piece of rubble from the wreckage and journey on. Too many times your heart will leave you stranded, and you'll bear the scars of where you've been. Don't be afraid to ask for new direction and journey on. Journey on, hold your head above the water. Journey on, you can weather out this storm. Journey on, there's a better day. And it's a better day than you have ever known. Journey on, someone's waiting by the river, waiting there to take you by the hand. So make the most of all that you